Hello everyone and welcome to the 1.91 development server, where today we're going to be taking a look at two new American jet aircraft, the F-89B and the F-89D Scorpion. Now the Scorpion is primarily an all-weather interceptor which was used by the United States Air Force. In actual fact, the Scorpion grew out of a contract to replace the P-61 Black Widow. This contract was actually published in late 1945, and the Scorpion first flew in August of 1948, eventually going into full production and having over 1,000 units produced, and it was actually in service until 1969. Now, the F-89B is actually the second production variant of the Scorpion, and actually had only 40 units produced, with a main armament of 6 20mm cannons mounted in the nose alongside a radar system. On the other hand though, the F-89D variant was the most produced version of the Scorpion. Almost 700 of these were built, and actually this variant removed the 20mm cannons and didn't replace them with any other gun. In fact, they actually took the front section of the wing end fuel tanks and converted them into a giant rocket pod, which mounted 104 Mighty Mouse unguided rockets. Now, unlike what you might think, these rockets are not to be used for air-to-ground. They are in fact primarily used as air-to-air. The F-89D actually had a radar system that allowed for it to track an enemy target and sort of tell the pilot where to aim the rockets to get an accurate hit. For the most part, this was used to take down heavy bombers, intercept them, take them down with the unguided rockets. So, of course, in War Thunder, Mighty Mouse unguided rockets can also be used as air-to-ground, so this is another use for this aircraft. Now in game, both of these aircraft are at a BR of 7.3, and both of them hold a premium status, so you will actually get extra RP and Silver Lion gain with both of these aircraft. These vehicles, of course, being premium means that you will have to buy them with Golden Eagles. The first of the two, the F-89B, will cost you 7,540 Eagles, and the second one, the F-89D, will cost you 3,770 Eagles. Another something worth noting is that you will have to own the F-89B before you will actually be allowed to buy the F-89D variant, a very similar situation to the Boomerang Mark 1 and 2. So starting off with the first of the two variants, the F-89B, in the hangar we can of course see that it does have some limited armor plating near the front of the cockpit, and then a piece of bulletproof glass on the canopy, so you do have a bit of protection there from the front, and this is the same case in the F-89D. Of course, you also have use of the nose-mounted radar and the 6 20mm cannons. More specifically, these are M24A1 cannons, which, you know, they're mounted fairly close together and in the nose, so aiming these at long and short ranges should be fairly simple. Unfortunately though, neither of the models of the F-89 in War Thunder offer any additional camouflage options, which is a shame, as I would have liked to have seen some of the more colourful paint schemes that these aircraft had in real life. Going into a test flight though, we can see that the aircraft has a fully modelled cockpit. This is the same for the D variant, as the cockpit model is essentially exactly the same. At this point though, it is clear to see just how big the aircraft is compared to the crew in the cockpit. Actually quite a big aircraft, and a very large surface area for enemy aircraft to shoot at due to its large size, which, you know, is a bit of a negative, but doesn't completely let the aircraft down. The aircraft does also have air brakes, which essentially split the aileron. This is actually the same design, the same technique, that is used on the A-10 Warthog attack aircraft. As I take off, you will notice that the aircraft also has an afterburner. Now, this actually allows for decent acceleration on the takeoff run and a fairly quick climb to altitude, which would make sense as this is an interceptor aircraft. Once I get to altitude, I do have to accelerate a bit to catch the MiG. The acceleration doesn't take too long thanks to the afterburner, which does actually help considering the size and weight of the aircraft. That little extra bit of acceleration is useful. Once I get up close to the MiG though, it doesn't actually take long to shoot it down. These guns, you know, the first hit I get sparks, I then miss another burst, but then the third burst I fire actually hits the enemy aircraft and, you know, pretty much just obliterates it in one shot, which does make sense considering it is 6 20mm shells fairly closely clustered together going straight into the back of that aircraft. Of course, the guns can also be used to take out ground targets, in this case some small boats and a truck, although destroying bigger things such as medium tanks is unlikely, as this vehicle can only use the guns, and at least on this version of the dev server, does not have access to any additional ground attack armament. Another thing to mention is that it's quite noticeable how the aircraft bleeds off its speed in a turn and in the vertical, which really does remind you yet again just how large and heavy the aircraft is, at least in comparison to other fighters at this BR. So now moving on to the D variant, we have a few changes here. Firstly, the guns, they're gone in favour of 104 Mighty Mouse rockets, which of course in real life were used as an air-to-air weapon, despite being unguided, but in-game, being Mighty Mouses, if you want, you can use them as an air-to-ground weapon to take out ground targets, or whatever you may please. Now, the D variant also has slightly more powerful engines, going from 5,100 pounds of dry thrust on the B variant, now to 5,600 pounds of thrust on the D variant. Of course, that's dry thrust, that is without the afterburner. With the afterburner, you will see even more of a power advantage over the early variant. Now, this variant also has a different radar, which in real life was used to help correctly lead the rockets to hit their target in the air, although in-game it appears this radar does not yet work, so hopefully when the update comes out this does work, and we can maybe use that to try and get some nice kills with the rockets against other aircraft. Another thing to note is that the F-89D can actually also mount some additional ground pounding capability in the form of 16 HVAR unguided rockets, which, you know, they're fairly common on the US tech tree, and really I don't see why the earlier variant doesn't get these either. Going into a test flight, I didn't actually notice a major difference in acceleration or climb rate from the B version despite the additional engine thrust. This could be a flight model issue because it's still work in progress, or it could just be that this is a heavier aircraft due to the additional rockets and of course the HVARs that I put on the wings. Now as said, this version has a different radar that actually should at least have a lead indicator to help you guide the unguided rockets into enemy aircraft. This doesn't currently work by the looks of it, so I'm not actually able to comment on using the rockets as an air-to-air weapon effectively, although, you know, after a while of trying, I was able to eventually hit the MiG-15, and when I did hit it, it died pretty spectacularly. So, you know, you can destroy aircraft with it, it's just, without the radar, it's going to be a tad tricky, but hopefully by the time we get to the live release, we will have an actual lead indicator, so you can then lead the rockets and actually get some solid hits on enemy aircraft. As far as ground pounding though, it's not exactly easy, at least not initially. You see, it's a big aircraft, the wingspan is about 19 meters, and the rockets are out on the very end of the wings. That's quite a big gap between the rockets, and they fire in pairs, one from each wing, so you're not going to get both of them to hit the target unless you have it perfectly ranged to your gun convergence, which I believe the gun convergence does affect these, although I might be incorrect there. Still though, it can be a bit tricky. Now, what I tried doing was I did test it at various ranges. The boats were fairly easy to destroy as they're fairly big targets, at least compared to the tank. You could take them out quite well. The tank, though, I had issues taking that out from most ranges. Really going in, doing an attack run, you need to aim to one side, get the actual height right, and then if you get a hit, it should destroy it, but it is kind of tricky. I think this is just going to be a case of practice a bunch and eventually get used to the leading and where you want to aim to hit the target. And once you've done that, you should be able to use them. Then again, you know, I don't know about this aircraft. I think the D variant is more of sort of a collector's item. It is obviously a lot cheaper than the B variant. I think the B variant is the actual one people are going to use in air games to do some grinding with, because it's got the guns, it has some merits that make it usable. The D variant, though, I think it's more of a collector's item. It's just a nifty little thing. It's like, oh, it's not got guns, it's just got unguided rockets. You got to spam them at the enemy aircraft, kill them. Yeah, you know, I think it's just a collector's item, really. The B, though, on the other hand, I can see that being competitive in air battles. The 6 20mm cannons, quite effective against most targets, and the acceleration and climb rate, they ain't half bad either. So I think this is good, although to sum up, I would actually say the F-35 Sabre is certainly still the better option for the United States premium jet. Obviously, higher BR, probably going to earn you a little bit more SL and RP. And I would say the performance at its tier is probably pretty damn good still, despite facing some supersonics. Anyway, that's more or less it for now. I will take a look at these, of course, on the live server. This is the dev server, so everything here, as said, is subject to change, and these flight models will likely change, the radar will likely be improved, and just generally anything on these aircraft, any stats, anything could change. So I will take another look at these on the live server post-release and actually see how they are, how effective they are, and really if they're worth buying. Anyway though, thank you very much for watching. If you did enjoy, please consider smashing the like button. Maybe even subscribe to the channel if you do, that would be very much appreciated. I will have after this video a few more 1.91 dev videos coming out. Firstly, British helicopters, then the new German helicopters, and also the Chinese Hawk 3 biplane, which is actually a tier 1 premium that no one probably cares about, but I'm going to make a video on it anyway. Thank you again for watching, and I will see you in the next one.